Thank you, madam, for the invitation. Actually, the preferred practice pattern, I don't know what exactly it is for ODP, it's quite confusing. It's not that difficult, I mean, rare a case. Quite often we come across in this case, at least we operate 2 to 3 every week, actually. So it's not that rare thing. It's quite male and female are equally affected. And we get even multiple pits also. So this is how it appears. It appears like a gray or white or yellow or a black thing. There may be a variation. The reason I am saying is the first preferred practice starts with the diagnosis of the OD pit. I'll just show you, this was a case. You have to identify, this was diagnosed as a case of a CSR. So this girl underwent every other investigation, believe me, by a retina specialist. By saying this, I am not saying I have not done this. Maybe a few years ago, even I would have done this mistake. Maybe my boss, Kim sir, is there. He might be telling whether I have done that mistake in the discussion. So they have done the FFA, nothing has come. Then they found there is some temporal palate. They sent it to neuroclinic, actually. The only thing they do is to do MRI, actually. Ultimately, when the case was sent to us with a 90 diopter and OCT, yes, this was diagnosed. So diagnosing, OD pit starts with the diagnosis. Diagnosing OD pit is the most simplest thing. All you need is a 90 diopter lens. Whenever there is a case like CSR, look at the disc always. So all CSR are not CSR, it may be a OD pit with maculopathy. So look at the disc, look for the grayish thing, and sometimes you'll come across 2 or 3 pits also. So this is about the diagnosing. And of course, you will have a multi-layered fluid when you do the OCT. And again, I'll not go into the detail because our other thing. So we have got a lot of treatment options. In case in the OPD, if the OD pit is incidentally detected, if they don't have any maculopathy or if there is no loss of vision, just observe and counsel the risk of development of maculopathy so they can be kept under regular follow-up. They can go up to yearly follow-up. Don't go for any prophylactic laser because when you calculate the risk versus benefit, it is more detrimental. In fact, it never should be done. Because with ODPM with vision loss, there is always a spontaneous resolution in 25% of the cases, but we don't know which 25% because we always get that the rest 25% to us, and this 25% which resolves spontaneously always goes to our competitor, actually, in my opinion, because the one which never settles are the one which come to us. But when it settles spontaneously, the visual outcome is poor, so when you find a maculopathy, go for the surgical management. Usually, if you are going to observe this case with the maculopathy, it is not justified. A very aggressive surgical approach is required. So these are the basic, the treatment option for OD pit. The first one is laser alone. Okay, so it basically induces the juxtapapillary colorectal scar. Thereby, it acts as a barrier for the fluid to migrate from the ON optic nerve into the macular area, and it is quite infective. So actually, these are few cases which we have done laser long time back. It might look nice, actually, but if you see the macula, it's gone, totally degenerated. The outcome is bad. That's why I've written, actually, for OD pit laser alone, you have to write the obituary for this treatment, actually, like how you have written for your smallpox. ODPM laser is an obituary which has to be written. So the other options available are we can go for surgical management. So before that, you can just inject gas with or without laser. But if you see, the results are not that great, actually. Macular buckle, yes, you can do. But it's quite a demanding procedure, number one. And number two, actually, you have to be a very good, trained retina surgeon. And number three, it's quite expensive. And the cost is also quite prohibitory. And quite a complicated surgical technique, actually, to start with. Once if you master, everything is going to be very simple. And it's not widely accepted as a treatment option. The other most widely accepted treatment option are inducing the PVD, right? Thereby you release the forces. So along with the vitrectomy, these are the things which we are using. So you just go for laser treatment. I said no more, it is done. Then you can do an ILM peeling because the fovea is going to be very thin. And if you're going to peel the ILM, there is every chance that you might create a macular hole. So people have done the fovea sparing ILM peeling also, but this is not done anymore because we have got other options. One of the options is just plugging, because whether it's a macular hole or OD pit, whatever we find, we want to just plug it into the, the OD pit and the macular hole. So one is the ILM, the other one is the, the scleral plug, okay? So we have compared all these three. So this is one of the case where we have done the ILM plug, and the second is the, the scleral plug. It's a very simple technique. After doing a complete vitrectomy, the videos are not playing. Okay, so after doing the vitrectomy, infronasal or infrotemporal quadrant, just with the crescent blade, make a small, raise a small, partial thickness scleral flap. Okay, trim it as per the thing. If you see, it's all three plugs, ports are 25. But usually, negotiating this into the 25 is very difficult, so one port is converted into 23. And usually, I do it under the air. After doing a complete fluid air exchange, you just take the plug and snugly fit it into the OD pit. That's it. There is no bleeding happening. It's not that difficult. That's it. And it stays for at least 1 or 2 years. Tena, one more minute. Okay. Yeah. Sorry. So these are the cases with OD pit. So the result, if you see what has happened in our case, actually, all these three were compared. When you see, actually, complete anatomical success was achieved in equally in the scleral plug as well as ILM, but the vision is better in ILM case. The reason we found is like when you are plugging the scleral plug, there is every chance that you might be damaging the retinal nerve fibers, but it doesn't happen so in this. But the scleral plug is very good or very useful if you have multiple plugs. And even if you lose the ILM when you are doing the surgery, as an alternate, you can always use a scleral plug. And it proves to be a very good option because the resolution happens within 3 to 6 months because it has an intimate relationship with the optic nerve, and it is a relatively easy to obtain the scleral plug rather than the ILM plug. And the ILM plug never that snugly fits, and there is a higher stability if you're plugging it with the scleral plug. But there are certain problems, like you can have the mechanical damage to the optic nerve, or you can have bleeding, but rarely it happens actually. And there is some silhouette artery occlusion also, which we have not come. And we have got cases with double pit, triple pit also in the same eye. And they do well with this, because as I said, ILM is not sufficient for filling multiple. And we have done, now currently under review, we are using the, PRP. It's not a pan-retinal photocoagulation, it is a platelet-rich plasma, which we harvest from the patient just before 20 minutes before the surgery, and at the end of the surgery, just 2 or 3 drops over the optic disc, and then close it with the gas. The results are quite encouraging. Maybe once it is done, we'll do it. So this is how we do that: 18 ml of blood with 2 ml of ACD, and then centrifuge twice. You get almost 10 lakh per cubic millimeter platelet, quite good for this. And platelet-rich plasma is an antibiotic, except for Klebsiella, it acts against every other bacteria, so just don't bother. Even in endophthalmitis, you can try this if your antibiotics are acting. The other adjuncts are, for want of time, I'll just skip. People have used plugs also. Okay, so in conclusion, diagnosis is very, very important. It can be done just with a 90 diopter lens. You don't need any sophisticated instrument, but any case of CSR, as I have told, or any case with a serous detachment over the macula, look at the disc, look for any pit, and then you proceed for further investigation or accordingly. There is no role for prophylactic laser. Never do that. In case if it is incidental finding, you can observe, but once the patient develops maculopathy, go for surgery. Vitrectomy is the most common. We do both ILM peeling and scleral plug. Plug gives a very good result. Maybe other adjuncts in future, we'll get to know what the results are. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you for that nice presentation. Dr. Mallika, you would like to share your thoughts on the presentation?
It's a good presentation. That's good. And I agree that not in every case ILM stays there. Possibly if you put visco on the ILM flap, it may stay. That has been my experience. So I think it's a wonderful presentation. And a good thing which you mentioned is that laser should not be attempted. Most of the times we see that people have attempted laser first and waited for a few months or years and then gone for surgery. Best to go for surgery.
And of course, diagnosis also.
Of course, everything's
diagnosed. Dr. Avinash,
sir.
87, 85, yeah. and 25 actually. It's not 100% and it takes time. But it's quite early in case of scleral plug, slightly delayed in case of, and in case of ILM, ILM peeling alone, it takes a very long time. It never settles rather. So actually in the first, plug, it is 3 to 6 months. In fact, after 9 months also, it never resolved in case of just ILM peeling with the gas.
Thank you, sir. We would like to invite the next speaker.
Just one additional point.
Sorry.
The symptom for diagnosis, the disc which has the pit is always larger.
Yes.
So that's something which can be looked at when a suspicion of optic disc pit with neurosensory detachment is thought of. And number two is if the configuration of the fluid which has a bottleneck going towards, if we have a patient with central serous, but it bottlenecks towards the optic nerve head, that's another time when people have to consider a possibility of optic disc pit.
Yeah, with the due respect to all our glaucoma colleagues, actually, I forgot to tell one thing. The field effects in OD pit can mimic any of the glaucoma fields. So they should not think that it's glaucoma and treat it with anti-glaucoma medication. Better they can send it to us. Thank you.
Thank you so much.